Hey guys, welcome to episode number 8 of the Hylian Herald. In this show, I talk about everything about Zelda, predictions, rumors, news, and even speculation. In this episode, I'm gonna do something a little bit different and kind of give my thoughts, feelings, concerns about the sequel of Breath of the Wild. I'm gonna go very loose and very fast. I have a lot of ideas and thoughts on my mind, so it should be a really, really fun video. But before I begin, I do need to say that this video is for my subscribers. So I'll give you a minute to hit that sub button. Alright, there's not much more to say than sit back, grab your favorite snack, enjoy the video, and let's go! Yeah, so it's been a long time since we've gotten any news from Nintendo about the sequel to Breath of the Wild. I know some other fans like Metroid Prime 4 have been waiting a little bit more, been longer for news, but it's still been forever. So, you know, it just makes your mind wonder, what is this game about? And so I have a few questions and a few thoughts. I mean, and the first one is, how far after Breath of the Wild does this game take place? Is it like directly right after? Is it months later? Like, how far is it? Is it a different story entirely where years have passed? Or did Zelda and Link gather their things after the events of the first game and just like go on and go to those caves? Because that's all we know about this story so far, is that there's some sort of caves. And you know, when we're on that idea, one of my biggest questions, I think everybody's question, is how involved is the story gonna be in this game? As you know, in the first game, there was some story in the beginning, and then there were all these optional memories that you could get. A lot of people didn't even get them, but I did. I mean, I'm sure if you're watching this video, you probably got all the memories too, but a lot of people didn't get the memories, so the story like was there, but it was kind of loose. And you know, when you get the memories in different order, it kind of makes it weird and it's not a cohesive story. So there is an overarching story in the first game, but not a thick one. I'm hoping that in the sequel, they really jam-pack the story elements in. Even if that makes the experience a little more linear, I'm okay with that. If you get a real good story, you care about Zelda more, you care about Link more, you care about other characters. You know, so I think a story is definitely one of the biggest questions I have. And in any story, there's got to be a good guy and a bad guy. So who's going to be the bad guy in the sequel to Breath of the Wild? Or Breath of the Wild Part 2? Is it going to be Ganon? Is that Ganon in the trailer that's all mummified and all disgusting looking? Or is it going to be somebody new? I know in the new Hyrule Warriors, there was a new bad guy. Maybe in the sequel, there could be a new bad guy also. I personally think it's going to be Ganon, maybe a different alteration of him. But we're definitely going to have Ganon in this game. And I know I just talked about the new Hyrule Warriors game, and that's a prequel to Breath of the Wild. So does that mean that the sequel to Breath of the Wild is the third game in the series? I personally don't think so. I think I'm going to take that Hyrule Warriors game as a spin-off. And this is, I'm going to say this quickly, I do think that Breath of the Wild is going to be a trilogy. I think we're going to Breath of the Wild, the sequel to Breath of the Wild, then another game down the road. I just think this game is too epic. And you know, in big epics these days, always need to have trilogies. So in the trailer for Breath of the Wild, all we've really seen is Link and Zelda going through some underground caves, possibly falling through some rocks, possibly discovering some glowing hands, maybe seeing Ganon or some other mummified being. We're not 100% sure. So my question is, what is the world that we're going to be traversing going to be like? Is it going to be a totally brand new world of an underground Hyrule? Are we going to be going through places that we've already seen, but maybe an earthquake shakes things up? There's a lot of questions. I personally do not think we're going to be seeing the same world that we've already discovered. That'd kind of be a little lame. Maybe the very, very beginning of the game, you're traveling some areas, but I think it's going to be a totally fresh new experience. I mean, maybe if aliens come down or there's huge earthquakes and Hyrule is totally transformed, it wouldn't be that bad. Or if there's like a dark version of Hyrule, it wouldn't be that bad. I definitely think it's going to be new, and I would love to see some new stuff. There's obviously going to be underground areas. When I think underground, I think of dungeons. And you know what? People were clamoring for dungeons in Breath of the Wild. I know we had the Divine Beasts and all the shrines, but I want real thick, puzzly, enemy dungeons that take me an hour, 2 hours to solve. Give me a new world, give me dungeons. Turbo Jesse will be a happy, happy person. So if you're watching the trailer also, kind of towards the end of it, you kind of see it looks like an earthquake, or you almost see like Hyrule Castle rising. Is Hyrule Castle going to rise into space like Mario Galaxy? Are aliens going to take Hyrule Castle? Is Zelda going to be trapped in that castle? Are we going to have to make our way up to that castle somehow? I don't know. All I know is that I saw Hyrule Castle shaking and raising just a little bit. Just a little bit. In one of my previous episodes of the Hylian Herald, we talked about unused content or unused images that I found, and there was one picture of Hyrule Castle on an island up in the sky with some sort of being on top of it. Could that be a foreshadow, or could that use that content in this next game, the sequel to Breath of the Wild? I don't know. I wish I did. If I knew, I'd be pretty happy. Another main factor to the trailer was that glowing green hand. At one point, it looked like it grabbed Link. Like, what is that? I personally think that that hand is somehow going to possess Link. And instead of using the Sheikah Slate in this game, that hand is going to transform into all sorts of things. Maybe it'll transform into a sword. Maybe it'll transform into a boomerang. God forbid it transports into the hook shot. I'll say it again, hook shot. That's right, I want a hook shot so badly in this game. And I think that hand, or maybe it's this arm, one of the arms is going to be a huge point in this game. It's going to be a huge plot. Or maybe a plot, but it's going to be a huge part of the mechanics of Breath of the Wild Part 2. So, glowing green hand, important. I know there was some sort of hand in Majora's Mask 2 in the toilet. This is going to be a different hand. Different hand entirely. So, the glowing hand should give us new powers in my mind. So, that makes me think, what powers or abilities are going to go away? Are all our champion abilities going to be gone? Probably, and we're going to be given brand new ones. I mean, do you really need to get pushed up into the air if you have a hookshot instead? So maybe you don't. And then, you know, it gets me thinking, are the champions going to be in this game? They probably should be, right? The ancestors of the champions should be in this game. So you should have their powers maybe there somehow on that castle in the sky too. I doubt they're going to be playable, but one character that might be playable is Zelda. And let me tell you why, right? Very often when media and movies and video games, whenever a female becomes badass and starts to be an action star, they always make her hair short. I don't know why that is. I'm not on board with that sexist crap, but it's possible. And also, I listened to a conversation that was had on Nintendo Life recently, and they said that maybe Zelda's hair was cut short so she could wear all this different costumes and different outfits without her hair clipping through the back of them while she's performing all these fights. So it'll just be easier to program her if she has short hair and moving around in all these different costumes. So that's definitely something to think about. And I know it's a little weird. I would love Zelda. I would love if there's two different characters and you have to switch between them at certain points in the game and they play different. I don't want to be able to switch between them at any point in the game. I know like Grand Theft Auto 5, you could switch between three characters at any time. I would like it if there's designated areas where, you know, maybe Zelda is really quick and she climbs really well, but she's not a good fighter, and Link is a great fighter, but doesn't climb very well. One game this was done very poorly in was Marvel's Spider-Man. Whenever you were Mary Jane or Miles Morales in the game, it was like boring stealth section. So let's not do that. Let's make Zelda a badass. Very badass. Talking about badasses, the end of Zelda Breath of the Wild, Link was a badass. You had every heart, you had all his abilities. You were a monster. You could just rip through that game. You were like a hot knife to butter, just slicing through all the bad guys. So somehow, Link is going to have to lose his powers, lose his hearts, lose all his abilities. I know, like, what was it? Metroid Prime 2, Samus gets hit with some sort of laser and loses all her powers from the first game. So somehow, Link is going to have to be drained of all his energy. Maybe that hand drains him. Maybe Ganon takes all his hearts and that's how he gets powered back. But, I mean, we're going to have to bring Link and Zelda back down to Earth a little bit. You know, just so, you know, you're not OP, you're not a god in that game. What else do we have here? So I guess we have the big ones. When are we going to get more information about Zelda Breath of the Wild Part 2? And when is this game going to come out? I mean, are we talking about a holiday 2021? We're talking about holiday 2022? No, I can't think that way. I'm going to hope and I'm going to pray that this game is coming out this year, holiday season, 2021. 1. And if that's the case, we need to hear some information about it soon. I doubt they're going to do one of those things where they reveal it at like June E3 and then, you know, it's only a few month build up because it's a huge game. I know this is going to be crazy, but I think we're going to get information on this game in the March-ish area. So in the next few months, I think we're going to get information on the sequel to Breath of the Wild. I know people are saying that, oh, maybe it's going to come out with the Switch Pro. Well, that'd be great if it does, but it's not going to be an exclusive. I mean, Nintendo sold like 60 million Switches, and they're going to want every one of those people that bought them to buy the new Zelda. And they're going to want it on the Switch and the Switch Pro. So we could be getting this game soon. You know, I just say that because, you know, Nintendo's definitely making a new 3D Mario 2, and that would be great for 2022, but 2021 needs to be the year of Zelda, and they have the big 35th anniversary right around the door, so we could really be seeing a lot of Zelda games soon. And if we're seeing a lot of Zelda games, we're going to be getting a lot of Zelda news. That means we're going to need new rumors, we're going to need speculations, we're going to need my thoughts. So there's going to be a lot more episodes of the Hylian Herald. I've done a lot of stuff to kind of have my channel be kind of a Zelda-ish channel, but there hasn't been that much news recently, so I've kind of been focusing on Mario or Nintendo or PlayStation 5. But this is a Zelda channel. That is the backbone. That is the spine of this channel. So get ready for a lot more episodes of the Hylian Herald. But what I really want to know is, when do you think the sequel to Breath of the Wild is going to come out? And what are your hopes? What is like one thing that you really, really, really hope is going to be in the game? Guys, thank you so much for watching this rant. I had a great time just doing it. I wrote the notes earlier today. I'm just really hyped. I'm hyped for this year. I'm hyped for more Zelda, you know? I think I'm going to stream some Zelda tonight. You know, I really want to do the Trial of the Sword. I did it once when it first came out, but the Trial of the Master Sword, I think it'll be fun to play again. And I do stream twice a week, every Tuesday and Thursdays with In Between, and make about 3 to 4 other, you know, original topic videos. Guys, thank you so much for watching this. If you want to support the channel, just watching this video is great, but if you want to support it a little more, you can join my Patreon for $1 a month. You get your name at the end of all my videos, just like this right here. I also have a Discord, I have a merch store, so click on the links down below if you're interested in any of that. But most importantly, think about subscribing, hitting that like button, so next time I go live with content, you get it right away. Guys, this has been Hylian Herald episode number 8. I'm Turbo Jesse. I'll see you on the flip side.